Hey everyone, it's Jackie and I'm here today with my July favorites for you guys. And before we get started, I just want to let you guys know that I am doing Vlogmas on my vlog channel. So I will be vlogging every single day throughout the month of August on my vlog channel, and I'll have that linked down in the down bar for you guys. Let's get started with my favorites. So the first few products I have are hair care products, and I've been using these products throughout the whole month of July. I'm still testing them out, but I do so far really like them a lot, and they are products from Macadamia Natural Oil. So I have here the Rejuvenating Shampoo, the Nourishing Leave-In Cream, which is just a leave-in conditioner. I have the Deep Repair Mask, and also this little guy, which is the Healing Oil Treatment. So let me tell you guys about these first. So I use the shampoo, you know, whenever I wash my hair, and I don't wash my hair every day, so I wash my hair like every other day. So I use this. It's color safe, even though that doesn't really apply to me. I don't really color my hair. It's sulfate free and paraben free, and it just smells delicious. I don't even know how to describe it. So I use this in the shower, and then when I get out of the shower, I will use the Nourishing Leave-In Cream. So I'll just pump a little bit on my hand and put it on the ends of my hair and just leave it there, and then let my hair air dry or blow dry it, whatever I'm doing that day. They smell really good. I don't know how to describe it. I wish I knew how to describe scents, but these smell amazing. And then the Deep Repair Mask I use about once or twice a week, but I'll put some in my hair from the roots to my ends, but mainly concentrating on the ends, and I'll just like leave my hair, and I leave it in for about 5 to 7 minutes, and then I wash it out. And my hair feels so silky and soft, and my hair looks a lot shinier when I use it too. So I've definitely been loving this. They all have the same really good smell. And then the last little guy I have for Macadamia Natural Oil is the Healing Oil Treatment. And I use this after I style my hair. So today, like after I straightened my hair, I took a little bit of this onto my palms, and then I just run it through the ends of my hair, and then whatever's left over, I'll go through my roots. But I mainly like to try to take care of my ends because they are dead and fried and just so gross. So, and those, all of those can be purchase at flatironexperts.com. I'll have the link in the down bar for you guys. If you guys haven't heard of flatironexperts.com yet, you guys are missing out. That is one of my favorite websites to shop at, and I don't know if you guys can tell, I do mention Flatiron Experts a lot. I've been mentioning them since I was recording on a webcam for that long. I've been a huge fan and loyal customer of Flatiron Experts for the longest time. So I got all of those from flatironexperts.com, and they also have a lot of times gifts with purchase, so that's always nice. And speaking of flatironexperts.com, I don't know if many people know this, but they do carry nail polishes as well, and that moves me on to my next favorite, which are these Deborah Lippmann glitter nail polishes. These are the only Deborah Lippmann nail polishes that I own, and I got these from flatironexperts.com as well. And I decided to go with the glitter polishes because like normal color nail polishes you can pretty much find anywhere, but it's really hard to find a good glitter nail polish, and so far these have been amazing, especially this one. This one is called Some Enchanted Evening, and I have it on my nails right now. So here on my nails I have Some Enchanted Evening, and I love it so much, and underneath that as like the base color I have Julie G's nail polish from Jessie's Girl. The color is called Julie G and it's a coral color. Oh my gosh, it's just so pretty. I'm obsessed with this glitter color. I've honestly been wearing this one, Some Enchanted Evening, throughout all of July, and I didn't wear it with this like coral color underneath. I actually use like a bubblegum pink. I don't have it with me, but it's from Shaney Cosmetics, and it's just like a Pepto-Bismol pink. Pepto-Bismol is a medicine for like upset stomach, diarrhea kind of stuff. But it's like this bright bubblegum pink, and I used that and then this on top, and it was like the most beautiful, delicious looking combination ever. Like, I wanted to eat my nails. I like this. The coral is really pretty, but the bubblegum pink and this color is just to die for. I love it. And then I have yet to try this one. This one is Happy Birthday. I haven't tried it yet, but I have this one on my toes right now, and this is called Across the Universe. It is beautiful. I do wear it with like a base color underneath, but you really don't need it because this one is really dark and opaque, so I like this one a lot. For the glitters, I really like the big chunks in them, so I really try to get those on my nails. So I put about 3 coats of glitter, which is kind of a lot, but what can you do? I really like opaque glitter. So those are my favorite products, and all those can be purchased at flatironexperts.com. Moving on, I have some drugstore products. So I recently did the $20 makeup challenge, and I used no e.l.f. products at all, but then right after I did a back to school like yearbook picture makeup tutorial, and I use all e.l.f. products. And there are 2 products in there that I use that I've been really loving throughout the month of July, and I've always loved them, but I kind of forgot about them and I pushed them to the side. And so when I used them for that makeup tutorial, it reminded me how much I really love these products. So the first one is the e.l.f. Butternut Quad, and this is only $1 and it's so pigmented. The colors are really nice for an everyday natural look, but they're like extremely pigmented so that you could make like a super dark, dramatic, smoky brown eye if you wanted to. But I just like to wear it for a natural everyday look, and I just love this quad. If you are new to makeup and you're kind of nervous, I'd say pick up e.l.f. It's only $1 and play around with it. So I've been loving this quad a lot. I've been wearing it a lot throughout the month of July. And then also another e.l.f. product is the e.l.f. Shimmering Facial Whip in Lilac Petal. I used this in that tutorial as well. I like to compare this to Benefit's High Beam because they are very similar, but I think the e.l.f. one is more, I don't want to say obvious because that doesn't sound pretty, but it's like an obvious glow. The Benefit High Beam is very subtle, but this one is like, whoa, you got a glow on your face. I love this. I don't really know how to describe it, but I love this a lot. Again, it's only $1, so why not try it out for yourself? It does get a little watery, so you kind of like have to shake it sometimes, or like put it on your hand to mix it, because it does get watery, so that's a downfall, but it's beautiful. It looks so beautiful. So I have 2 more favorites. I hope this video isn't too long. But the next one is a blush that I've been loving. It's from Too Faced and it's called Mocha Mi Amor, and it looks like this. You know, I don't know if you guys get like this, but do you have those days where you want like obvious blush, but you don't want to look like a clown, but you want like, you want to use your blush as a blush and contour type of thing, so you want to have it a little darker than normal. So like, this is very natural for me, but when I use this blush, I like to really pack it on and make it a lot heavier and kind of make it contour my face as well as give color to my face as well, if that makes sense. I use this in my Katy Perry makeup tutorial if you guys want to see. That is typically how I like to wear it, like pretty dark and heavy like that. And my last favorite is a perfume that I have been wearing nonstop ever since I got it, and I think I actually got it in June. I could be wrong, I can't remember, but it is a perfume from Benefit, and it's called See and Be Seen Sasha. And I'm not 100% sure if this is out yet. If it's not out already, it should be out very, very soon. But yeah, this is their newest perfume, and like I said, I don't know how to describe scents, but this one smells so good. It's like different from the typical perfumes that I have. I usually like really light, florally, or even sweet smells. It smells deeper, if that makes sense at all. It's a lot sexier. That's how I describe it. It's a lot sexier smelling. And I love it. Kind of makes me feel a little more grown up when I wear this. I know that sounds silly, but so those are my favorite products that I've been loving throughout the month of July. I'll have a list of all of the products on my blog as well as the down bar below. And before I go, I want to mention my favorite YouTuber of the month. So this girl, I've been watching her videos for this entire month. I discovered her videos when I was at IMATS LA. She was in the NYX Face Awards competition, so you guys may have already seen her or heard of her, but that's when I like found out about her, and I really regret not actually meeting her in person. She is so adorable and so cute, and I've been loving her videos, and her channel is Beautylicious Insider. She is just so cute and adorable. I just want to pinch her cheeks and squeeze her. She's so cute. So I love her so much. Please go check her out and tell her Jackie sent you. If you already know her, or if you're already subscribed to her, just tell her Jackie says hi. But if you're not and you're new to her channel, please tell her Jackie sent you and Jackie loves you. So yeah. Those are my favorites. She's adorable. You guys are gonna love her. She's so cute. I think that's all I have for this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed my favorites video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye, have a magical day.